Let's see how you can obtain robust longitudinal findings with data from multiple cohorts. I'll show you how we did this in our evaluation of self-control development in adolescents. We had data from 3 cohorts from the consortium Individual Development. Almost 500 radar adolescents filled out self-control items in 2 questionnaires. Furthermore, over 10,000 twins from the Netherlands Twin Register reported on their self-control issues, just as more than 2,000 adolescents of the TRAILS cohort, as well as their parents, who even filled out 2 different questionnaires on their child's self-control issues and capabilities. All cohorts represent Dutch adolescents, so this seems a good start to end up with robust conclusions on self-control development and associated sex differences. But how did we combine the different measures of self-control? For that we used Bayesian evidence synthesis. We started with constructing a set of competing informative hypotheses based on previous research. We also included an alternative complementary hypothesis as a failsafe. Similarly, a set of informative hypotheses was constructed to evaluate differences in development between boys and girls. It was expected that girls would have higher initial self-control, but higher self-control in boys was included as a failsafe hypothesis. The set of hypotheses was evaluated by computing the Bayesian posterior model probability for each hypothesis according to each measure in each cohort separately. We see that the best supported hypothesis varies across studies. However, after aggregating the evidence, it becomes clear that the hypothesis of self-control development, in combination with recovery for adolescents with lower initial scores, is the only one supported by RADAR and NTR and the TRAILS adolescents and the TRAILS parents in both questionnaires. With respect to sex differences, we found most evidence for boys having higher initial self-control levels according to the adolescents in NTR, RADAR and TRAILS. The TRAILS parents, however, provided most evidence for consistently higher levels of self-control in girls. We conclude that there is most aggregated evidence for self-control development with recovery for those who start with lower initial self-control levels. With respect to sex differences, we see that boys report higher levels of self-control than girls, but parents allocate higher self-control levels to daughters. This evaluation clarifies that the self-control informant may have great impact on the outcomes. Bringing the evidence together showed that results often differ between cohorts and measures. Focusing on one cohort, even a large one, may provide a biased view with respect to the population. Interpreting the differences between cohorts and measures can lead towards important insights. Meanwhile, Bayesian evidence synthesis shows which hypotheses are supported consistently. This is how we obtain robust results and more interesting discussions.